5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, ignition.
Are you high right now?
Absolutely.
This is AC Primetime Radio.
The people that are watching the pageants aren't necessarily the people that we want coming to Atlantic City.
Let me stop you for a second. Are you high right now?
I don't think the tax base is going to drop anymore.
He's running a $100 million annual budget deficit.
81% now up to 96% in municipal tax with this increase, and 163% in the school tax.
If he were the CEO of a company, he'd be fired.
I think we hit rock bottom, but there's no deal. Boardwalk Hall. Boardwalk Hall. Vacant homes, abandoned homes. Yes. My Bugatti is selling for $900 million more than they were valued.
But there's no deal.
My house was selling for $300,000 5 years ago. It's selling for $125,000. We're not going to allow them to do something that's unconstitutional. High number of foreclosures.
But there's no deal. Are you high right now?
Yes.
But there's no deal.
But we're looking for the millennials.
Are you high right now?
Yes. Absolutely. I think we hit rock bottom. I know that they were working very hard to try to get a group in Boardwalk Hall. They were working with, I believe, AGN Live Nation. Miss America, they certainly do a great job of showing off the city. The people that are watching the pageants aren't necessarily the people that we want coming to Atlantic City. Not that we don't mind grandparents and little girls,
right?
Bart Gladstein, but we're looking for the millennials. Boardwalk Hall, Bart Gladstein, but we're looking for the millennials. Boardwalk Hall. They were working with, I believe, AGN Live Nation.
Making Atlantic City great again. This is AC Primetime Radio.
But we're looking for the millennials.
Live from the home of Miss America. It's time to reimagine. Redevelop. Reinvest. And track the reinvention of Atlantic City. This is AC Primetime Radio with Mel Taylor.
It's no secret, Atlantic City Mayor Don Guardian, not a fan of Miss America. Now that's preposterous. That is unfathomable. The bow-tied guy, he'll be on stage with the ladies for photo ops, sure. Mayor Don, he'll even get front row center seats inside Boardwalk Hall for the Miss America pageant. But he's not a fan of Miss America. He's told that to Bloomberg News. That's right. He actually said the other day, we don't want those who watch Miss America on television to come to Atlantic City. You see, Don thinks that those who watch Miss America on television are just preteens and grandparents. You know the contract with the CRDA? The contract between the CRDA and Dick Clark Productions, who takes care of the Miss America pageant on television. The CRDA had the ability to be featured on New Year's Eve Rockin' Eve with Dick Clark, if he was still alive. But of course, Ryan Seacrest, he's hosting it now. And you heard the story, right? Atlantic City said, or actually nobody has been blamed yet. They're all pointing the fingers. It's certainly not Dick Clark. Is it CRDA? Is it the city of Atlantic City? Huh? How could you not want to have a camera pointing at Atlantic City on New Year's Eve? So you can't get a band. If you can't get a band, no big deal. There's plenty of totally exciting, over-the-top, crazy DJs playing in front of 1,000, partiers on New Year's Eve, that's what you want to show to the rest of the world, that Atlantic City is more than just a rock band inside Boardwalk Hall. Why wouldn't you take that camera, that live shot, and why wouldn't you put it inside of a casino in the DJ booth? And then you pan from the DJ and you pan to the left and you see that crowd of millennials. Exactly what Mayor Don and the CRDA claim they want to attract. They dropped the ball.
This is AC Primetime Radio.
It supports my mindset that I've been sharing with everybody for the past year or so. That Atlantic City, with all due respect, has zero skill set in regards to running this town like a miniature Las Vegas. They don't have the skills. They don't know how to put on shows, how to market entertainment. They don't know how to do it. Not even the Atlantic City Alliance really knew how to do it. They did some good things. Very expensive, very little ROI. The deal with Live Nation, hey, one of the better promoters, right? They're one of the big heavyweights in the country. Live Nation is one of the big players in the concert promotion field. And then the other one, the other big heavyweight, is AEG. And they got to remember that Live Nation has the ability to get their bands and book them inside Boardwalk Hall. But they also have to book these big bands in Philadelphia, in parts of New York and New Jersey. And sometimes these acts do not want to play too close to a Philly date or a North Jersey date or a New York date. They think it might kind of dilute their attendance. Live Nation has a problem with putting big bands in Atlantic City, mainly because they want to keep their Philly venues happy and profitable. And North Jersey, that's what I think. It just makes sense. Because why wouldn't they want to put a band, a big band, a profitable band, inside Boardwalk Hall or on the beaches of Atlantic City? It has to do with the economics and the potential dilution of that act and ticket sales. So it's complete BS that there was scheduling conflicts and other issues at hand. Atlantic City has such a negative reputation all across the country, all around the world, with all the negative press that gets out. Even though, between you and me, you know, the ones that live here and who ride bikes and drive our cars up and down every street, well, almost every street, and spend all of our time here on Absecon Island, we know what's going on here. We know the good. We see the growth. We see Stockton being built. We see that boardwalk being quickly built. We see all kinds of activity. But the rest of the world does not see that. And because we couldn't get a band to play inside Boardwalk Hall, somebody or some group of people said, well, can't do it. Because Live Nation, according to the newspaper, they were out of the loop weeks ago, if not months ago. Imagine that. And of course, the CRDA had to pay for the production of having television crews inside a Boardwalk Hall or could be anywhere. But for some reason, they thought that in order to be on television, to get in front of 59 million viewers New Year's Eve, the rockin' New Year's Eve telecast with Ryan Seacrest, they thought they needed an A-level act. Well, there's plenty of A-level entertainment going on that's incredibly compelling to a millennial. And that's inside those nightclubs with those DJs. And it's not just a DJ and people dancing. It is more than that. It's a full-blown production, lights, excitement. A millennial say, wow, I didn't realize Atlantic City was so hip. But no, somebody dropped the ball. We all dropped the ball. We all dropped the ball by letting them get away with it. I can't believe that the CRDA issued a statement saying, though we hoped to sponsor a New Year's Eve performance at Boardwalk Hall this year, well, scheduling conflicts and other considerations have redirected our focus to the 2017 concert calendar. They just thought everything revolved around getting a big A-level band, which Live Nation couldn't do. Live Nation had trouble getting A-level bands this past summer, right? They were struggling to get bands like Blink 182 that were really cool about, you know, 10, 15 years ago. Live Nation cannot get these bands And I believe it has to do mainly with these bands are playing the bigger markets that are too close to Atlantic City. Or the casinos don't want those bands to play on the beach. Those casinos want those bands to play inside their buildings because they can get those concert goers to gamble. Can you see the conflict here? Can you see why Atlantic City can't get out of its own way? We dropped the ball. We are not going to get in front of 59 million viewers on New Year's Eve in front of the types of people that definitely, that must see the fun and the all-new Atlantic City. It doesn't have to do with Boardwalk Hall or an A-level, fairly expensive band. We got to get some smart people that know how to run concerts, that are entrepreneurs, that are more than just managers, more than just politicians.
Leaving local radio and newspaper in our digital dust. This is AC Primetime Radio with Mel Taylor.
I am grateful that someone of the caliber of Glenn Straub wants to even consider doing business in Atlantic City.
But we need to see him actually do something. I mean, he's been you know, putting up these, I'm going to have this open by that, and you know, he comes with these dates with the state that
yeah,
he,
but you know what, David? At least he's trying, and you continually bash him. At least he's trying.
Whoa.
Wow.
Trump bill.
69. Now it's time for new believable people, and we must do it. If we don't control insiders, this will be over and over. To lead it by an egg, big fat love.
Whoa, wow. Trump bill.
America first. Love the flow.
Let me stop you for a second. Are you high right now?
ACPrimetime.com and AC Primetime Radio, sponsored by Lacey Cleaning, the best in carpet cleaning and construction site cleanups, turnover service for those who rent out their properties. Make sure you reach out to the man. He is Chad from Lacey Cleaning. Call him. The best. LaceyCleaning.com. That's L-A-C-E-Y cleaning.com. And AC Primetime Radio, also sponsored by Get Smart Digital, the fastest growing digital marketing and online advertising company in the Atlantic City region and all of South Jersey. Visit GetSmartDigital.com.